Hello everyone, I'm Teacher July. I'm really glad to see you again. Today I'm going to talk about Flipgrid. So what is this Flipgrid? In short, it's a video blotting board platform. It makes much easier for students to make their own video to respond to the contents and to share them with the rest of the class. It offers quite a good quality of service for teachers for free. Due to this COVID-19 break, ironically, now we fully realize that interacting is the most part of the education, and Flipgrid makes that part possible. I'm going to cover detailed features later in my other video, but today, I'll just show you the basic features of the Flipgrid for you to start right on. Let me walk you through from the very first style of using Flipgrid. First of all, we need to create an account. Go to this educator sign up here. Just click on it. You can sign up with your Google account. They will ask some basic information about yourself, like your country, grade, and subjects that you are teaching. Just fill out them and click on Start My Grid button here. And I'm in my grid now. A grid is basically like your classroom. So you see I have several grids named after my classes, like class 6-1, class 6-2, like that. Just click on this Add a New Grid button here to make your class. It says name your grid here, so usually I would name this after my class, but in this case as test class 1. And you have to select a grid type. I prefer student ID setting here, because with this setting, students don't need to go through the process of making their own account. They just need the free code and their ID, which I can make for them easily. Okay, so click on them. Click on student ID. And the last part is create a free code here. I can customize my own free code at the back end of this URL for students to remember better, like this as test class 1, and it's available. Okay, also note that this URL is for my entire grid, not for just particular assignments. Just click on next here. Okay, since I select the option to go with student ID grid type, I can get to make my student IDs. So you can just write your student's names, like, and create their accounts, student IDs, like this. You don't need any private information to make student IDs. Okay, so click on this add. So you can do this one by one like this, or you can download template file from here and fill out with your students' names and IDs. And after you upload your students' IDs, just click on here next button. You can print out the list if you want, in case you know students forget their IDs and ask you about them. It happens all the time. Click on launch my grid button here. Then they say your grid is ready. Okay, go to your grid. So as you can see, I have my grid right here. I can add up a co-teacher by clicking on add a co-pilot button here. You can type in co-teacher's email here to invite them in. You can share your grid with them to review and give some feedback to students. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do. Okay, let me show you how to give assignments to students. Okay, then we'll talk about what it will look like on the student's view and the teacher's view. Just click on this add new topic button here. Okay, think about a topic as an assignment, right? So click on it. Write the topic of the assignment. Your summer vacation plans. In this prompt box here, just write the description of the assignment for the students. Okay, so number one, use the pattern that we learned, B.2. And the second one, okay, talk about at least three things that you want to do and why. And one of the nice things that Flipgrid offers that I can set the duration of the recording time. I think 1 minute is enough, considering that I have to grade over 200 students. Focus feature. Okay, that means you can add up some media resources. I usually add up some funny GIFs, so click on here, add a GIF. I will search for a happy. Yeah, but thinking of a vacation plan just gives you a smile, right? But also here, oh, I like this one. Select. Yes. Okay, let's talk about this video moderation feature briefly. I prefer turn on that option because I want to check the videos that students submitted, whether there is inappropriate part of the video for the other students, or maybe some of the students have revealed too much of their private information on the video. I need to be a gatekeeper for them before the whole class to see them. So if you are all done, just click on this create topic button here. And I create my topic. It gives me a flipgrid here. You need to share this link with your students via QR code or the link itself. Or if you are using the Google Classroom, just click on the Google Classroom button. Since I'm using Google Sites, I will just copy this link and embed it in my Google Sites. So just click on All Set. Now let's see how it looks like on the students' view. Your students can download Flipgrid app on their device, or they can type the link on their computer that you get them. It's what it looks like on their computer. So enter the student ID and hit let's go. On their device, they can see the title of the assignment and the description of the assignment. And the most important thing is this big green plus button below. When they are ready, just hit this button to record their response. Okay. First, for students who don't want to show their faces in the video, there is a pixelated filter like this, and also stickers. Okay, you can resize them like this way. I think it's one of the best options that Flipgrid offers. These days, as a teacher, we need to advise students to be careful what they're uploading on the internet. And also, you can write on the video directly, or you can add a sticky note here. Is a drawing function here, right? You can draw directly onto the video. Okay, if you are ready, just hit this record button and there's a countdown. Okay, I will talk about my summer vacation plans. You can trim the video if you want to, like this. And for the last part, this last part, students are going to take a quick selfie. This selfie is going to be a thumbnail for their video. Once you're ready, just click on this camera here. You can add a filters, stickers, or text if you want to. Okay. Just take a selfie and click on next. The submit video. Complete. And back to teacher's view. Okay, let's see what it will look like. You can see the student's video by clicking on them. I will talk on my and after that, the feedback, I can give visual video feedback for them and also grade on their ideas and performance. You can customize your own rubric from here, custom feedback, add criteria, right this way. And also, I can just write, good job. After I grade them, and I can go back here and turn this active. In that way, the other students to be able to watch this video and give their feedbacks. I think this Flipgrid can provide a social platform where students can interact with each other in meaningful ways. And also, it gives more efficiency for teachers who have to check the students' performance and give them feedback in the remote learning. That's all for today's video. I hope this video useful to you. If you found this video helpful, just click the like button down there and subscribe to my channel. Good luck with your remote class. Have a nice day. Bye!